I'm gonna call you during my break, yes.
Wait, what time do I have to be there tonight?
Huh?
What time?
7:30. Don't be late, okay? It's the same place.
Of course I won't be late. When am I ever late?
Good.
I'll be back tonight.
Thank you.
So proud of you.
Oh. No, I'm running late. Thank you, Mom.
So proud of you.
Okay, bye.
Say she needs a bit more time to adjust before they take it any further.
I don't think that's a good time right now. I'll call you in a few days and we'll sort something out. I will do, yeah. Say hi to Ella and Tim for us. I will do. Thanks, Harold. Bye-bye.
Wuthering Heights today.
I don't care, Mum. Whatever you want.
Come on now, cheer up. You're far too young to despair.
Too young? Mum, I don't have anything to look forward to anymore. So I couldn't care less what bloody Bronte sister you read to me tonight.
Elizabeth, language! Can we help you?
Listen. I'm terribly sorry. I just couldn't stop overhearing your conversation.
Oh, I think you could have. Mind your own business, please.
Wait, excuse me. I really apologize for eavesdropping, but I really think I could help you. I mean, help her.
Oh, how on earth do you think you can do that?
But you see, I'm a doctor. I'm an ophthalmologist, to be exact, and I really think I could help this young lady. I know this might sound really strange to you, but why don't you come both to my office tomorrow, 10:30? We can discuss all of this. Again, I'm terribly sorry. I apologize. Goodbye.
Erick ?
Oui.
Votre rendez-vous est là ?
Très bien, faites-le entrer.
Oh, go ahead.
Please, come in, sit down.
It's so great to see you again, Miss...
Elizabeth, but you can call me Liz.
Liz. So I must say I was not expecting you both, especially after our encounter yesterday in the park. I must apologize again. I'm really terribly sorry to have intruded so violently, but I couldn't not intervene. I mean, I saw your daughter and I really
thought... Look, I appreciate your concern, but I still don't understand what it is you do here, or how it is you think you can help. I mean, you do realize that she's permanently blind.
Mom?
What, Lizzie? We're at the doctor's. So what is it you think you can do? You can't just laser her vision back, can you?
No. That's right. I can't just do that. That is completely impossible. And I'm afraid the only transplant we have is a transplant of the cornea, which is the outer transparent part of the eye, and that would be, in this case, absolutely pointless. However, we have new systems, we have new technologies, and I've seen already 20 cases of full eye transplant that actually are really successful. Let me explain it more clearly. If you have a look at this, basically, you see this cornea here.
She's very beautiful. Is she your girlfriend?
No. It's my sister. She passed away. Anyway, let's go back to Elizabeth, shall we? So, my dear. My dear. Ah. But anyway, about Elizabeth. The procedure itself is pretty risky. But I have to tell you, you are in the safest of hands. I really think you could trust me. And as we know, she already has lost 98% of her eyesight. So I really don't think there is much to lose. And I really believe that it can only be a win-win situation here. Imagine having your daughter back with her sight again and her seeing everything as before, as once she did. Well, there is only one thing I have to tell you. You might have to change eye colour, if that's not a problem.
Well, Izzy, what do you think?
I don't know what to say. It all sounds strange and surreal, but yes, if that means I can act and dance again, then I wouldn't mind if one was green and the other one was yellow.
Wait, we have to think about this. I mean... You know, what if something went wrong? You have to consider all the consequences. You have to be sure.
What do you mean? Of course I'm sure. So what if it doesn't work? Nothing works anyway. I can't do any of the things I actually enjoy, and I'm sick and tired of those crappy walks in the park and having to listen to you reading me those stupid novels. Mom, I want my life back. I have to do it. I'll do it. Yes, doctor, I'll do it.
Yes? Great. Fantastic. I really believe, Elizabeth, you're doing a very wise choice here. And don't worry. You're normally, you won't regret it, and neither will you. In less than a few weeks, I'll promise you, you will have your sight back and be able to do what you love. And be on stage again.
The oomph. Yeah. The oomph. Of course you are right. Yes, let me just give you some of it. You came just in time for funerals, Stella. Is that what you want? Yes? Is that, you know? No. This is stupid.
Please.
I'm leaving. Okay. Bye.
Erick, what is happening to my little girl? She's not the same anymore. Just be honest with me, she's not the same, is she? Is it because of the side effects of the medication? I'm really worried for her. I think she's becoming bipolar. You have to do something. You promised me I wouldn't regret this. You have to fix her.
Come on, Erick, throw it away. I can't bear to think how ugly I used to look. Just get rid of it, okay? Why I stopped drawing. I've missed it so much.
Your hair. It's different.
Huh?
You've changed your hair.
Oh yeah. Do you like it?
Mm-hmm.
I hated how it was before. It didn't look nice. This is more me. Stop it!
Oh, God.
You're suffocating me!
Am I?
Don't you have that dinner thing to go to?
No. I've cancelled. So you might want to just spend some time with me. Just you and I. You even booked a table at Sketch. Apparently you're not in the mood. Then I guess you'll be glad to know that I'm leaving to Paris tomorrow for a week.
Thank you. are you? No, 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 no,